Hello friends, in this video we are going to see depth first traversal technique in graphs. The idea in depth first search is pretty simple. Given a graph, we have to go forward depth wise while there is any such possibility. If not, then we have to backtrack. The term backtrack here means that we have achieved a dead end, so move back and choose another path. Let's learn depth first search with the help of an example. Consider the graph as shown. We have 6 nodes labeled A to F. Now we see that these nodes are connected and traversing them can get us stuck in an infinite loop. So how can we fix it? The solution to this could be to have a boolean visited flag for each node. This flag will be true if we have visited a particular node, else it would be false. Since we have more than one node, we will use an array of such flags and will call it a boolean visited array. Let's quickly see to the ingredients required to get our depth first algorithm running. We will require a graph, a stack data structure, and an output array. Initially, our stack is empty, and all the nodes are unvisited. Note the color representation of visited and unvisited node, and also for better visualization of the algorithm, we have shown the stack in a vertical manner. Now let's start our algorithm with this starting vertex labeled A. We push it into our stack, print it as an output and mark it visited. Next we look at the adjacent unvisited nodes of A. Till B and C holds the criteria. We may pick any of them. We will go and choose B. Push node B into stack, print it and visit it. Now we look at the unvisited adjacent nodes of B. Node D and node E are the required neighbors. We choose D, push it onto our stack, print it and also mark it as visited. Now we look at the unvisited adjacent nodes of B. Vertex E and F are the nodes that satisfy our given criteria. We choose vertex E, push it onto our stack, print it and also visit it. Now let's look at the adjacent unvisited nodes of E. We find node C and F as the one that holds the given criteria. We push F onto stack, print it and also visit it. Now we see unvisited adjacent nodes of F. We find that all the adjacent nodes are visited and hence there is no way. So we backtrack. We pop node F from top of the stack. Now we have node E as top of the stack. We see for the unvisited adjacent nodes of E, we find one node which is C. We push it onto our stack, print it and mark it as visited. Now we look at the adjacent unvisited node of C. There are no such nodes. So we pop C from the stack. We now have E as top of the stack. There are no unvisited adjacent nodes of E. So again, we pop E from the stack. Now comes the D and again, we find that there are no unvisited neighbors of node D. We therefore pop D from the stack. D is the new top of the stack. We see that B do not have any unvisited neighbor. We therefore pop B from the stack. Now we are left with A. The two neighbors of A are visited and therefore we have no go and will pop A from the stack. We now see that our stack is empty. This will signal our algorithm to stop. We now take a pause and see that how all nodes are visited and also printed. We also see that traversing is done in a depth-wise fashion. Now think of how to implement it. A hint could be that we are using stack. Since we are using stack, we can implement it recursively or we can do it iteratively using a stack data structure. This is an example code which is recursive and same as that given on Geeks for Geeks. You can go through this code or implement your own version for the same. Let's quickly look at the complexity of the code. Depth first search visits every vertex in the graph and checks every edge for each node. Therefore, time complexity for depth first search is big O of V plus E. Here V are the vertex or nodes and E are the edges. We'll wrap this tutorial now. For any queries or doubts, please comment below. Thanks for watching.